Hey guys, how's it going? Today's video is going to be another book haul, but this one is going to be extra special because all of the books that I have hauled are going to be by authors that fall under the trans umbrella. So trans, non-binary, gender fluid, etc. Also, because I realized the camera kind of cuts off my shirt, it does say I'm not gay, but it does say I'm super gay. So don't worry. If you haven't heard me mention it already, on July 31st, to celebrate J.K. Rowling's birthday, I'm going to be doing a 24-hour readathon that I am calling #JKRReadathon. I'm going to leave the announcement video above and below, but basically to celebrate J.K. Rowling's birthday, I'm going to be reading books by authors of communities that she has spoken out against with hate. I'm going to be focusing mostly on trans authors because that's the community that she's spoken out the most against, or at least the most recently, and I just thought it would be great to celebrate her birthday by celebrating people that actually deserve it. Obviously, you don't need an excuse to be reading trans books or books by any minority, but I just got super excited about it and kind of went on a bit of a book buying spree, and I have 11 new books here. Before we get into the actual books, I just want to shout out a couple of quick resources that really helped me find these books. The first one is a Goodreads list that is for NB and trans spec authors, is the name of the list. I'm going to link it down below. It was created by Audrey, who is non-binary, and they're also a booktuber, so I'm going to link their channel down below as well. This list has over 100 books, and I'm just going to read the description real quick. This list includes, but is not limited to, authors who identify as gender fluid, gender flux, agender, trans, binary, trans non-binary, bigender, two-spirit, and so on. Another really great resource is Jessie over at Bow Ties and Books. I'm going to leave their channel down below. They are a non-binary booktuber who has so many awesome recommendation videos, and some of the books that I had purchased, afterwards, I had seen them talking about the books, and they just got me so friggin' hyped. If you want someone to really hype you out about books, go check out their channel because they're so good for that. And now, onto the books that I got. The first book I have here is Why Dust Shall Never Settle Upon This Soul by Rika Aoki. She is a trans woman who uses she, her pronouns, and she's also Japanese American. This is a poetry collection. I don't know too much about the specific poems in it. The back doesn't really give any insight to it, but I just realized it matches my shirt really nicely. That's cool. The back and the Goodreads page don't really give too much insight on what the poems are about or if there's any specific theme that weaves throughout all of them. From some of the reviews that I've seen, it seems like it's a lot about loss and remembrance and just very emotional. I don't necessarily read poetry for the story, I read poetry for the emotions, so I think that this is going to be very much up my alley as far as poetry goes, and I'm very excited to get to it. Next are three books that are kind of part of a series, but not quite, and that is Clean, Meat Market, and Wonderland, all by Juno Dawson, who is a trans woman and uses she, her pronouns. These books are all under the London trilogy, and from what I can tell, there's no like cross between any characters or anything like that. They're just three completely separate books that just happen to fall under the same name of trilogy, I guess. So starting with Clean, which is the shiniest book I've ever owned. It is very hard to hold up, so I'm sorry if I end up blinding you guys, but I'm doing my best. But this is about a rich socialite who almost overdoses and gets sent to a rehab facility. And it's basically their story and all of the strange other characters that they meet. From what I've seen, there are quite a few trigger warnings for this book, so if you're interested, definitely look those up before you get started. I know for sure that the main character is a drug addict, there's also a trans girl with anorexia, there's a sex addict, and there's also a character that has OCD, which is rep that I am personally very interested in. So I am just very interested in whatever the heck happens in this book. Next is Meat Market, and it's the story of a young girl who gets discovered by a modeling agency and is thrown into the modeling world and all of the like dark messed up things that go on there. But the main character is more androgynous and is very uncomfortable with her body and how feminine it is. And according to the trigger warnings I saw, it does contain some transphobia, but I don't think it has specific trans characters. So again, I have not read this book yet, but if you're interested about triggers, definitely look them up before you get started to make sure that this book is going to be okay for you. I am not somebody that's ever really been into fashion or modeling or any of that stuff, so it's not really a world that I know much about, but obviously I know that, same with any big industry, but there is quite a dark underbelly to the beast, and I'm very interested to see how this portrays that. And also, again, a beautiful, beautiful cover, very sparkly. And the third one is Wonderland. This cover is not as sparkly, but is also just really friggin' cool. Like, I am just really in love with all three of these covers. But this one is about a trans girl, and her best friend goes missing, and nobody seems to be looking for her, nobody seems to care. So she ends up going to this, like, party to end all parties, and it's just this really trippy, weird world. I've seen it described as, like, following somebody on a really dark acid trip, which, I'll be honest, I'm very, very intrigued by. from what I see, this one seems to be the most, like, sketchy with reality, if that makes sense, out of the three of them. Like, it seems to be kind of trippy, which, I mean, I'm all for. That sounds like a super fun ride. Also, the main character has some sort of mental illness and requires medication, and she gets lost there or stuck or something without her medication, so she's not sure what's actually going on and what's just her mind playing tricks on her. I don't know any details about what that is or how it's portrayed, but honestly, I really like the whole questioning reality thing, so even though I'm really excited for all three of these books, I think this one is going to be the most up my alley and the one that I am the most excited about. The next one is one that I've mentioned in a couple of videos already, but that is Out of Salem by Hal Shreve, who is a gender fluid trans man and uses Z and her pronouns. This story synopsis just makes me so freaking excited. It's about a gender fluid teen witch who is in a car accident with their family, and their family is killed, but they are brought back as a zombie, and now they have to team up with a elderly lesbian witch, I think, and a Muslim lesbian werewolf, and what more do you need in a book? Like, that is just so many amazing things that I'm just so interested to see how they all tie together. Again, I've seen this book has some trigger warnings that I would recommend you look into before you get into it. I do want to highlight one specific trigger warning that I've seen though, and that is for police brutality. But I know that with everything going on in the world right now, a lot of people are getting more and more triggered by stuff like that. So just make sure, again, to look into trigger warnings before you get into a book. But I just think this is going to be so freaking cool, and I am trying really hard to wait until the readathon to pick this book up, but honestly, I am so tempted to read it early, and it just, there's so many little elements that I'm so intrigued by, and I am super super pumped, if you couldn't tell. Next, I have the first two books in what I think is supposed to be a trilogy by the end of it, but that is Dreadnought and Sovereign by April Daniels, who is a trans woman and uses she, her pronouns. On Goodreads, there is a third book announced, and the author has said that she's working on it. I believe this is going to be a trilogy, but I'm not positive on that. I didn't want to look too much into it because I didn't want spoilers for the first book that I haven't read yet. This is another one that is super up my alley, I think. Super. It is about a superhero. This is about a closeted trans girl who kind of accidentally becomes a superhero because the original Dreadnought superhero ends up dying right in front of her, so she inherits their powers. And now she's a superhero and she finally has the body that she belongs in, and I don't know too much more than that. All I know is that she's not only dealing with sudden transition and everything that that entails and getting used to this new life and how people see her, but also having to fight an evil cyborg that killed the original Dreadnought. So I just think that that's going to be very, very interesting. I'm not positive what the sequel specifically is about because, again, I don't want to look into that and get spoiled for the first book, but I love superheroes, and this just sounds like a really unique superhero origin story, and I am so pumped to get to it. The one thing I'm a little bit nervous about is that I don't know if Sovereign ends on a cliffhanger, and where the third book doesn't even have a title yet. I'm really worried that I'm going to fall into the same trap that I always do of reading a book, getting really excited, and then not having access to the sequel for a while. But we will see. I will still probably read this very soon, but superheroes are my jam. Next, I have two books. They're unrelated, but they're by the same author, and that is Pet and Freshwater by Akweke Emezi. I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing that right, but when I looked at the pronunciation, I had a couple that were completely different, so if I am pronouncing that wrong, I'm really sorry. But they are a non-binary author who uses they-them pronouns, and they're also Black, and I think a lot of their stories focus on Nigeria and Nigerian culture and folklore and stuff. Starting with Freshwater, it is about a young Nigerian girl who experiences a lot of trauma and is a, like, fractured self. It's not a DID type thing. They have multiple obonje in their body. I've tried to look into it a little bit and I don't 100% understand it, so I'm really sorry if I make any mistakes with this explanation here. But it's basically an evil spirit in Nigeria that haunts families, usually by becoming children and babies and continually dying just to get reincarnated and dying again, and just the vicious cycle of loss. Based off of that, and that it mentions that there's a lot of trauma for the main character, definitely look into the trigger warnings before you read this book because I have a feeling there are a lot of them, but I'm really excited to get into it because honestly, I don't know enough about Nigeria and Nigerian stories, and I'm really interested to learn more about that, and I think that this book will obviously help me with that. From what I understand, this book is also loosely inspired by some of the author's own experiences and their own life, so I think that that's going to be something that's also very interesting, but I have a feeling that it's going to be very heavy. Next is Pet, which I think has a lot more fantasy elements from what I understand. This takes place in a utopian society where all evil and monsters have been eliminated and everything is great and perfect, but not. Our main character is a trans teen who accidentally brings a monster out of, I think it's one of her mother's paintings. And from what I understand, that monster is a literal monster that then says that there are real monsters, and from that I assume they mean humans, that they have to go and fight and find, etc. Again, the premise is a little bit confusing to me just because I don't know the world, so the context I don't quite understand. But I really love monsters, I find it a concept that's really interesting, and I really like the take that literal monsters and humans being figurative monsters and stuff. I really like that dynamic and that take on things, so I think that this will be very up my alley. As far as other rep goes, I also heard that this is an entirely black cast, and also the main character's best friend, their parents are in a polyamorous relationship. I believe that they have three parents, and that's just rep that we really don't see very often. Again, I don't know how well the representation is done because I have not read the book and I'm not polyamorous, but definitely look up Own Voices reviews if you're curious about that. But that was definitely something that intrigued me. There's just a lot of elements in this that all really grab my attention, and I have heard so much praise for this. Jesse from Bowties and Books has talked about this so many times, and again, every time they do, I just get so friggin' hyped. So I'm probably gonna read this one very soon because I am so pumped. Next is another poetry collection, and that is When the Chant Comes by Kay Ulande Barrett. They are transgender and use they-them pronouns. This is a poetry collection all about their personal experiences, and there is quite a lot of variety from what I can tell. It's essentially a collection of their different experiences being trans, queer, Asian, and disabled. So again, that's more rep that I personally know that I don't read enough of. And again, like I said, I really like poetry that is very emotional, and I think that authors speaking so much about their experience being in so many different communities, I think it's going to be very interesting. I don't know what the overall tone for this poetry collection is, but I kind of didn't want to know, so I didn't want to look too much into it. But I think that it's just going to be very interesting just seeing all these different pieces of their life and how they all fit together and how their identity shapes their experiences, and again, emotional poetry is my favorite. And last but not least is Gender Failure by Ivan E. Coyote and Ray Spoon. Ivan Coyote is non-binary and uses they-them pronouns, and Ray Spoon alternates between referring to themselves as a non-binary and a trans man, so I'm not sure if they do prefer one over the other. I couldn't find that out, but they do seem to refer to themselves as both, and again, they use they-them pronouns. This is a collection of autobiographical stories, essays, poems, lyrics, photos. Like, it seems to be quite a lot of variety, mostly revolving around their experiences with gender. I think that it's going to be really interesting to see all of that variety, and again, I don't read that many anthologies, so I think that one having so many different aspects to it is going to be really, really interesting. And also, I like the fact that it's like an autobiography, but of two people. I've actually never seen that done before. I don't really know too much more than that, but I think it's just going to be very interesting to see all the different stories, the mixed media, the two different people. Like, I think that that just overall, together as a collection, is going to be very, very interesting to see. And there we have it. Those are the 11 new books that I got. I really tried to have as much intersectionality as I could. Obviously, reading trans stories is important, but reading a variety of trans stories, reading from trans people that have very different experiences, that are part of other minorities, like, we need to get a very well-rounded view, in my opinion. I'm also really excited about the variety in the stories themselves. So nonfiction, fiction, poetry, fantasy, reality, dark. Again, I just think there's so much importance to reading voices that are usually overlooked and spoken over, and a variety of those voices who tell a variety of stories. I feel like sometimes, not only with trans authors, but with other minorities or other groups, a lot of people kind of tend to try to cram them all into one box and expect them all to be the same or have the same type of stories. And they're all human, so that's not realistic. So that's my rant, slight tangent, but I think it's important to mention. And again, you obviously do not need an excuse to be reading trans stories, but if you want to participate in the hashtag JKR Readathon on July 31st, that is a Friday, I'm going to be doing a 24-hour readathon. I do want to mention also, though, if you're working that Friday, if you're busy that Friday, you can do it the day before if you want, the day after, that weekend. Like, obviously, I wanted to have it on J.K. Rowling's birthday as kind of, Honestly, a big fuck you to bigots. That's where this whole idea came from. But the main important thing is lifting up these voices, expanding our reading, and giving these authors more attention, because a lot of these stories are ones that I've never heard of, but I feel like I should have heard by now based off of the type of books I read, other recommendations and whatnot, but so many of them just aren't mentioned. And I think that just lifting up all of these voices is going to be the most important thing. So obviously it would all be nice to be reading on Friday, but if you can't, still try to incorporate this. If you still want to do a 24-hour readathon or a 12-hour readathon or just read for an hour that day, whatever you can do, honestly, every little bit is important. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please click the like button to let me know and subscribe to stay up to date with the rest of my videos. I post new videos every Wednesday and Sunday, usually reading or writing related. So I hope to see you guys next time, and until then, have a great day. Bye!